Kingstream Entertainment. Ruslan.
All right, so the new song Bless God, I want to do the deeper meaning behind the concept, right? What does it mean to bless God? Many people don't really understand. They're like, oh, they see me wearing the hoodie and they're like, yo, what does this mean? What are you talking about? How can someone bless God, right? And I was like, you know what, let me do this kind of devotional for you guys so you guys can understand what I mean by what I specifically mean. We live in a time, in a space where one of the most desires by folks who know God, who don't know God, who are religious and not religious, is this idea of blessings, this idea of, hey, God bless you. May the Lord bless you, right? And we see this all the time. When somebody sneezes, they say, you know, God bless you. And it's interesting that we're so consumed with the blessing of God and we're not really consumed with the person of God, like the person of Jesus. And it's also an interesting time and space where life expectancy is down for the first time in multiple generations, right? Divorce is over 50%. And some studies even show that divorce is over 50% in the church as well as the world, that there's obviously a pandemic. There's obviously something wrong with the world and things are not going well. Things are not going according to our plan, right? And so what I wanted to bring add value, I guess, in a way, is what if we had a paradigm shift and instead of looking for the blessing of God, we looked for how we can live a life that's blessed and ultimately bless God with our life. So when we look up the definition of what it means to bless, just straight like bless definition, some of the pronounced words in a religious rite to confer, invoke divine favor upon, ask God to look favorably on, right? That's our modern definition, especially in Christian church services, right? But here are similar words, and some would say, synonyms: praise, worship, glorify, honor, exalt, adore, right? Those are some of the parallels to what it means to bless. It's like to exhort, to honor, to exalt, right? And I was like, man, I've heard this phrase growing up. I was around a lot of folks that were, you know, that got saved radically, and they came from a Black Baptist church type of background where this is kind of like stuff you would hear. Like you'd hear a preacher preaching and somebody yelling back, bless God, right? And there's like a whole cadence to how those sermons go. And I was like, man, I haven't heard anybody talk about this in this sense. So this is the state of being that we should have, right? 2 Timothy 1:7, and this is what an encounter with God does to us. This is what an encounter of God did to me, right? It says, 2 Timothy 1:7, it says, for the spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline. So the spirit that God gave us, right? The spirit of the Holy Spirit that lives inside of us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, self-discipline. Power, love, and self-discipline. And so for me, that to me is a reflection of where we should be. Where should our temperament be, right? Power, love, and self-discipline. And that is Jesus coming in the form of man and dying for us and, raising from the dead. And then saying that he's going to send us a helper, send us a spirit. And it says, for the spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline. Now, this idea of self-discipline, this idea of power, this idea of love, right? Not to get on a prosperity gospel kick, because I don't think it's just about finances. I think in their context, it probably wasn't much about finances at all, right? It was their mentality and how they were able to engage with the changing world and the tribulation and the tensions they were going through. So power, love, and self-discipline. Now, here's another verse that I think is super dope. It's Romans 12:1. And this is really the heart of this song. This entire record, this entire concept is anchored on this song, okay? Romans 12:1. This is what it means to bless God. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, right? God's mercy, Jesus's mercy, Jesus coming, living, dying, resurrecting, sending a spirit, in view of God's mercy. Mercy is also not getting something that we should have gotten. We should have gotten the wrath of God. We should have gotten separation. But in view of God's mercy, to what? offer your bodies as a what? Living sacrifice. Jesus died and rose. He offered his body, died, rose. And it encourages us to offer our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. One of the words you can use for bless is to worship, to praise, to praise God. And how? And what does it say here? It says to offer our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. So it's true and it's our proper worship. And then it goes on to say, and this is the verse that anchors this song together, but he goes on to say, which I love this passage, this verse as well, it says, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by what? The renewing of your mind, right? And if we go back to 2 Timothy, it says, He did not make us timid, but gave us power, love, and self-discipline. It says, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. Once we have that transformation and we're not conformed to the pattern of this world, right? This world has a pattern. And I've told you guys, I think the pattern of this world doesn't just lead to death in the afterlife. It leads to death in this life. Like, you keep going out and doing dumb stuff. You keep partying. You keep being reckless. You keep being greedy. You keep being the type of person that does not walk in the logos, walk in the mind, walk in the ways of God. And it will jack you up, right? It will jack you up. He says, but be transformed. We have to consistently be transformed by the renewing of our mind. Then you will be able to, so once you're transformed, then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is what the song and the concept behind the song is about in terms of blessing God, in terms of being being someone that lives a life that blesses God instead of just looking for the blesser, instead of just looking for the one who is giving you the blessing. What if the entire way that we lived was actually to worship God? We offered our bodies as living sacrifice, and in that we actually got what we were really after, which is a relationship with God, which is power, right? Which is love, which is self-discipline. And it says you offer your bodies as a living sacrifice. So it's a paradigm shift. Instead of looking for the blessing, you do the blessing, and then everything else shifts in accordance. So I've been talking about this idea of like the pragmatic side of following Jesus, that not only does Jesus renew our hearts, renew our minds, transforms us, and something internally happens, but the actual ways of God on this side of eternity, right? On this side of eternity work. They actually work, that he does not have to bless us, but when we live his way, we are in his will. And that doesn't mean that there's not going to be trouble. That doesn't mean that there's not going to be tribulation. That doesn't mean that there's not going to be, right, challenges. All that stuff is going to come, but it means that we will have faith and comfort in that. So let me know if you guys get the concept, bless God. Let me know what you guys think about the song. Be sure to listen to it on Spotify, Apple Music. Share it with a friend. Appreciate you.
Kingstream Entertainment. Ruslan.